Hello everybody, I'm Nicola. I mean, some of you may know me. I came to sing for you last year and maybe the year before when I was visiting New York. As you can hear, I'm English. I'm currently in the north of England, not far from where I'm from, and there's beautiful countryside around me, and I wanted to give you this gift of a video because I know some of you will be home alone, and this this self-isolation is not easy at all. It brings up a lot of stuff for every person, but we still have the power and the beauty of music, and I can pass that on to you. So it's with my pleasure that I sing some songs for you today and tell you a little bit about my time in New York, because I love New York. I think it's a fantastic place. So I thought I'd start with a really upbeat one by George Gershwin, and this is I Got Rhythm, because no matter what they do, I've got my rhythm and I've got my music. Here we go. Days can be sunny with never a sigh. Don't care what money can buy. Birds in the trees sing a day full of song. Why shouldn't we get along? I'm chipper all the day, happy with my lot. How did we get that way? Look at what we've got. I got rhythm, I got music, I got babadookas for anything more. I got daisies in green pastures, I got babadookas for anything more. On my travel, I don't mind if you to find our light within and, you know, hook onto that and help each other as much as we can. Simon, who I liaise with to do this, a fantastic guy, does so much to help people. I went to sing at the Henry Street Settlement. I went to see sing at the Nork on, is it Grand Street? Above the Apple Place. I went to sing for Diana Jones in Brooklyn, and everywhere I went, I got the most amazingly warm welcome from everybody. You are very, very, very warm, friendly, talkative people, and you make my heart soar. You really do. So I thank you today for being my audience, because at the moment I've got no audience apart from whoever is sitting listening. So I thought what I'd do is I'd sing the most popular opera aria that there is for women, because this is my thing, and I just thought, let's put some of that in, let's do a really good mix, and let's have a good kind of sing song, sit back and listen and that kind of thing. Okay, so this is Puccini's O Mio Bambino Caro, O My Beloved Father. Let's have a see. Hang on one sec. Here we go. I went to Henry Street Settlement twice and the reception, people clapping, people cheering. There was one particular lady and I just remember her smiling the whole time. And that just, I find that amazing. So what I want to do now is I've actually changed tack here. I was going to put this one in later, but I want to do When You're Smiling. When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. If I can find it. Where is it? I had it a bit ago. I was like, oh yeah, there it is. And now I can't see it. That's really strange. I just looked at it before we started and thought, oh right, yeah, I've got that one sorted. Right, I'll have to find that one in a bit. That's strange. But anyway, I'll do what I was intending to do anyway, stick to the plan. So the kind of link I've got is I'm from the north of England, I'm from a place just outside Manchester, but you know the Beatles were very prevalent when I was a child, and we all know which Beatle ended up in New York, and there's shrines to him in Central Park, Strawberry Fields, you know, great John Lennon. And you know, I used to love walking through the park, you know, going in the 72nd Street entrance, and there was always like a group of people all gathered to sing some John Lennon music and to look at this monument. And I don't know, I've always loved this song and I always loved the words, so I'd like to sing Imagine for you. And it's literally my popera version, which, so it's a bit operatic, but it's sticking to Imagine as well. I just really like the words for this. Come on, it's coming.
Yeah.
of John Lennon. It's only about an hour down the road where he's from. And, you know, when I've been to the cabin, it was called the cabin, wasn't it, at the docks. And when I was younger, obviously, I couldn't have seen him when he was around. But, you know, John Lennon, he's just such a special person, and I always kind of feel it. And, you know, he's got this absolute affinity with New York, and I feel a total affinity with New York. I just think there's a magic energy there. There's an amazing vibe, and it hooked me in. And then it's like I love every minute that I'm there. I love the life on the street. I love watching people. I love the vibrancy. I love the kindness. I love the creativity. Oh my gosh. I remember one time watching a guy doing ballet across the street near Central Park. He just kept running across when the lights went on red and did this ballet thing to have a photo taken. And I thought, you would only get that in New York. And it kind of feeds my soul. It's just brilliant. What I want to do now is I want you to take you back to my story. You know, we all know about, sorry, one second, I'll just put my computer down. We all know about the class system in the UK, which is not as prevalent in the US. But, you know, you're kind of born into a class. Now, I was born into working class. You couldn't really get much lower than what I was born into. And I wasn't from a particularly musical family. You know, they like the Beatles and that kind of thing, but not, I don't mean classical music. And, you know, had five brothers. We didn't have a lot of money. I know at one point my parents were on welfare, as you say it. So it was, you know, it was hard. But music found me. And I was given free trombone lessons when I was a child of seven. And then I went to the local music centre, and it opened up a whole new world. And when I was 15, a lady offered to give me singing lessons for free. And she introduced me to opera, because I had no idea what that was. And that was how my world began. And it's taken me all over the place. I've lived all around Europe. I've worked in opera houses. I've really, really enjoyed it. And I love the fact that I can sing for people. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to sing you the first song that I was ever given to sing in a singing lesson. And as I sing this, I will be picturing myself, because I just thought it was brilliant. I absolutely loved it. And then I was hooked on that. So it's from La Nozze di Figaro by Mozart, and it's Cherubino's aria Voi che sapete. Amore, dove vedete? about that little break in the middle. My machine just decided to stop working. And to be truthful, I could say, okay, gosh, let's get rid of this video now. Let's start again. But I don't want to do another video that's kind of a bit more pretend because I've already done it once and I have to do it again. I want it to be in the moment. So I hope you can appreciate that. And, you know, I'll just carry on. Now, one of the things that I did when I was in New York last year was I went to Philadelphia, never been to Philly before, and I met up with a Belgian conductor because I've had this idea. I used to live in Belgium as well, so there's that link. I had this idea that I wanted to write a tribute to Julie Andrews because I've always loved her as well. So I met this conductor who said he was interested and he just gave me lots of advice. I think he works at the main hall in Philadelphia. Sorry, I can't remember what that is. And he said, write your own show. So I did, and I've spent the rest of the day waiting for my bus back. And I went to the steps where, you know, they filmed Rocky, and I was like, yeah, I'm going to do it, and all this kind of stuff. And I spent the next 3 months researching her in the Lincoln Center Performing Arts Library, and I absolutely loved it. And I would get all these books out, and then, you know, I love the sun, because in the UK we don't get the sun so much. And I was on the beach with my Julie Andrews books, my Russian snacks, because they got fantastic Russian food from the ladies on the street there. And I would sit all day and I would read the books. And I always went on a Monday, and then I would go and volunteer at Lexington and 80th at a homeless place. Oh gosh, what's it? Monday Night Hospitality, where I just used to love it. Chatting to all the people. It's a beautiful place. They feed 400 people every week. It comes from the heart. There's some amazing people that go to eat, and I've heard the most amazing stories. And, you know, these are the things that kept me going when I was in New York, that gave me the joy every day. So I want to sing a Sound of Music medley, because I know how much you love Julie Andrews too. And, you know, it was the Americans that took her to heart and started her off and put her on Broadway in The Boyfriend and then My Fair Lady. You know, and she never looked back. So I thank you again for appreciating our British talent. So this is a lovely medley now that's the Sound of Music. So please sing along. Just put that there. That's it. Here we go. woolen kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are the few of my favourite things. Curdled and bodies and crisp purple strudels, doobers and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese and fly with a moon on their wings. These are the few of my favourite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when something sad, I simply remember my favourite things, and then I don't feel so bad. I know that I'm naive, and at my big fate, happy and sweet, and willingly I believe. I am 16, coming at 70, fellows may fall in line. Matured and these drinkers of brandy, offer me food and wine. Totally unprepared am I to face a world of man. Timid and shy and scared am I of things beyond my ken. I need someone older and wiser telling me what to do. You are 17, coming on 80, I'll depend on you. Now that's not my show. I actually did end up writing the show, and it's called A Spoonful of Julie, and I worked really hard to get it into theatres in the UK, and then I was going to come back to New York in June, and now it's all been cancelled. I've no idea when I will do it again, which is a little bit upsetting. Of course, you know, I'm sure we've all had plans and things that we were looking forward to, and it's hard to, you know, to accept that they're not going to go ahead. But I do thank you for taking the time to listen to me today, because that really helps me to keep going as well. You know, there's days where I don't feel good about things, and I want to be out there and I want to be doing things. So I appreciate this opportunity, and I'm glad that me and Simon had a chat and we worked out that I could do this. I also went to JASA in the Bronx as well, which, and again, the thing what the New Yorkers do is they show me love. It's like they just show you some love. They're so enthusiastic. It's like in Britain, we keep ourselves a little bit more reserved than that. But the Americans, they just don't care. They just say it like, go on, girl, you know. And I feel myself, I shine when I'm there. Now, what I'd like to do now is, I want to do a Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square. So a little bit of jazz. I have never performed this one before, and it's a new backing track, so I hope I don't make any mistakes. But do sing along. That very, you know, it's so romantic, this song. I always liked it. Let's have a go. Magic abroad in the air. They were angels guiding us. like gets you really upbeat. So I'm running out of time and I really wanted to do a few other songs, so I'm going to get onto it. Now, one thing I did do when I was in New York is I was lucky enough to sing in Central Park. So I got in with the musicians at the Bethesda Fountain and they gave me some slots and I loved it. It's a beautiful spot. I would go and people watch. And I got friendly with the guitarist there. It was called Carlos. And he would play this sometimes. He would be playing before I was due and I would sit waiting. There was a homeless guy called George and I used to go and chat to him as well. And this is literally one of my favourite songs. And we all know Elvis. And I watched a documentary on him the other week and I thought that man was special. So I want to do Can't Help Falling In Love With You. And this is Carlos who is playing in Central Park and I'm going to sing along to him. So I'm going to pretend I'm there. And that really is how I feel about New York. I can't help but fall in love with you. I want to live there. I want to be in the vibe. I want to help people. I want to sing for people. I want to do my Julie Andrews show for people. The other thing I run is Opera for the People. So if anybody would like to follow me on Facebook, I've got my own page. The more the merrier. Let me know, get in touch with me if you can get on there. Let me know if you want me to sing for you down the phone. I'll do you a little video myself for you, just a personal one. I'm just here to help. So my name is Nicola Mills, or Nicola as I was always called in New York. Nicola, N-I-C-O-L-A Mills, M-I-L-L-S, and my Facebook page is Opera for the People. My website is www.iamnicolamills.com. I truly, truly, truly look forward to the time when I can visit New York again. I haven't had a fixed address for 2.5 years because I've spent my time just keep coming back because I can't get enough of it. So I will be back. Now, let me find this one now. I'm trying to find this when you're smiling. Where is it gone? Let me see. A little bit of Louis Armstrong here. I can't believe it's just kind of gone. I just can't find the backing track, which is really annoying because I had it before, it was there. So if I can't find that and I want to do that one, I'm gonna look for a few more minutes and then if not. Oh, it's there. Why did it not? Right, anyway, when you're smiling. Downs, but if we can find a way to smile through that and find some of the good stuff as well, it does help us and find the community where I'm living. It's an amazing community. There's free food, I'm helping my neighbour getting her shopping, there's kids on the back, and you know, we kind of are all pulling together and helping each other out. I know, and I'm going singing for people as well, just to kind of lift their spirits, going to the doors and standing outside and things like that. So we can all be doing something as well to help somebody else, even if it's just a phone call to somebody, and it lifts them and it lifts yourself. So it's win-win. So Simon asked me to do 40 minutes and I've literally done 40 minutes. So like now. So I thank you all for being my audience today. I love you all. Please keep New York full of that great energy. It will come back. You know, this will not last forever. And, I thank you all. I cannot wait to get on the plane and get my backside back over there. So I have done my 40 minutes, but if you can bear to listen to a few more minutes, I'm going to do an encore. And because you've got to do an encore, haven't you? And this is the lovely Andrea Bocelli, Time to Say Goodbye. Or Sarah Brightman, whichever one you want to think of. Love you all, and I'm going to blow you a kiss. Goodbye.